Hello everyone, denoise here with ActionVFX. In this video, I'm going to show you some quick tips on chroma keying workflow. While I will be using Adobe After Effects and its key light effects as demonstration, these tips can definitely be applied to any VFX or video editing software. I also will have another green screen tutorial planned in the future, so click on the subscribe button so you don't miss that out. So before we begin on our main topic, I'm gonna give you two honorable mention tips on keying green screen, which are: first, denoise your plate first. You can use tools such as remove grain or plugins like reduce noise to remove the noise in your shot. This will help you get a smoother key. And then the second, create a rough mask around your subject. We don't want to deal with unnecessary stuff in the shot. Only worry about what we need to worry. Okay, so we have those out of the way. Now let's begin with the main tips. The number one tip on green screen workflow is to do multiple keying layers and combine them into one matte. Getting a good matte edge is not easy. Chances are, in your shot, you will have different parts that will require different level of keying. Like, you may want to have a soft matte key on the hair here, but also you want to have a solid opaque matte on the hand, and it's probably difficult to achieve both using one key light. So to get the best of both worlds, you want to duplicate the layer and do different keys on each layers. So on one layer, I am making a soft key on the hair and mask that area. And then on the other, I'm making another key for the hand and then mask that area of the shot. And there we go. We are combining more than one keying layers to achieve more accurate result for our shot. So the second tip is essentially just an extension of the previous one. Sometimes when you try to get a good edge on your mat, you ended up creating some holes inside of your subject. So to get around this, what we want to do is you want to create two sets of layer. The core key layer, which serves as the inner skeleton of the key mat, and the edge key, which is just the edges of the mat. To create a core key is very simple. All you have to do is to just focus on creating a fully opaque key of your subject without worrying about what the edges would look like. And then you want to shrink down the result. So now that we have the inner part of the key covered up, you can then create another key layers where you can just focus on getting good edges on your mat without worrying about creating some holes inside of the subject. And then the third workflow tip that would really help a lot is to have the alpha channel to be a separate layer from the RGB channel. In After Effects, the creation of the alpha mat and the masking of the RGB or beauty channel from the mat happens in just one layer, which isn't practical, especially if you have multiple keying layers in your shot, because that means the RGB channel that is being masked by the alpha is broken and scattered around in multiple layers. It is much better to group all the key layers into just one pre-comp layer. And then you want to bring your original footage back into the comp, and then we want to use the combined mat from the key to alpha mat our footage. Separating the alpha into its own layer makes our workflow a bit more procedural, because now you can play around with the alpha mat layer and the original footage layer without affecting the other. And now the fourth tip. Just because we are using keying doesn't mean that manual masking would not be needed. In fact, in chroma keying, masking is your best friend, not your enemy. For example, in this shot here, I still have this weird edge key on my forehead. No matter how meticulous I tried to get a good edge on the key, it just didn't work. So what I can do is to go to our alpha mat pre-comp, and let's bring back our original footage, and we want to do a manual mask on the forehead to patch the problematic part of our key. And then let's manually animate our mask, and we have fixed our edge problem. So this was before, and this is after we patch it with mask. And finally, the last tip. If you find other color information in your shot that will help you patch your key, use that. For example, I have this keyed out shot of a hand going over the screen. However, as you can see that I am losing some parts of the finger. That is because if we look at the original footage, the fingers received some green spill from the screen. So it got keyed away. Now of course, like on the previous tip, we can patch it with a mask. But here I'm going to show you another way. Here you can see that the green spill on the hand is way darker than the one on the screen. And it is more evident if we turn this shot into black and white using tint. So then what we can do is to leverage this black and white information that we have to help our key. So we can add curve to make this black and white color more contrast. And then using shift channel, let's turn our current color information into an alpha channel. And then we are going to shrink the matte a little bit using a simple choker and then blur it out. And then we want to combine the Luma key that we just made with the other key layers that we have. And there we go, we used luminance keying to patch our green screen. This luminance method can also be used to preserve more difficult details as well. I have made a separate dedicated tutorial for keying here that you can check out in the description below. In that tutorial, I went step by step on how to use the luminance key to key out hair details. And that was 5 workflow tips to help your green screen keying. If you have any other tips that you'd like to share, feel free to let us know in the comment section below. For the next tutorial, we will be covering how to use the tips that I just explained to key out a more difficult green screen shot. So subscribe so you don't miss that out. If you already have your keying taken care of, you're probably going to need some high quality VFX elements to go with your shot, which you can get anytime on our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. And see you next time. Bye bye.